The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet mesquite. Repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, ericsfamilybbq.com.
Eric's Family Barbecue has arrived and is simply the best barbecue in Arizona. Come satisfy your taste buds with meats that are smoked over mesquite wood and sides that are made with fresh ingredients and tons of love. They have the best, juiciest brisket, pulled pork, rib, sausage, turkey, or everyone's favorite, the Pitmaster Sampler that includes all the meat and four sides, mac and cheese, potato salad, coleslaw, corn, or beans. Yum! And for dessert, try some creamy banana pudding. Amazing! Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet mesquite. Repeat. Make the trip. You won't be sorry. Dine in or take it to go. Go to ericsfamilybbq.com for more info.
A little bit of everything. I do some singing, some dancing, some chatting with the guests, the skits, the monologues, the comedy.
Wonderful comedy.
It really is a lot of fun.
It is that time that we close her on up here, Brady. It's time for the entertainment drill brought to you by our friends over at ReactDefense.com, the home of tactical black self-defense. And if you're interested in getting involved in something that's going to get you in great shape, make you smart, we're talking about that this morning. A guy got his nipple bit off in a street fight. Doesn't matter how much you think you know. Street fighting's got no rules, man. They don't care about your nipples. That's where you get. That's where you start losing it. Keep that in mind at all times when you're walking on the streets. Nobody around you cares about your nipples and is willing to pull one off. People with bad intentions do bad things, and that's why it's imperative you get into this street defense thing with Tactical Black, because it teaches you, like, yeah, you might be a good fighter. You might be a good sport fighter. You might be really talented athletically. It doesn't necessarily mean that crazy is going to lose to you because you have a good uppercut. You got to learn how to use it, when to use it, what to do, and how to get out of there. That's the part. Almost all fights, like police officers will tell you this, almost all of them end up on the ground. So if you like punching, doesn't really matter, because if you miss, you're going on the ground. What are you going to do then? And nothing is worth your wallet. Nothing is worth your car. Let them have it. They teach you all this stuff. Escalation of a situation can be avoided almost every single time, and that's the best way to defend yourself. Not get involved in this garbage, and that's the best thing about Tactical Black. It's been around for 20 years for a reason. It is the best in the business. Ever evolving, and today, another evolution happens. Will you be part of it? That's easy enough. Go to ReactDefense.com and start learning, getting in great shape, and understanding how you can become a better you. Phoenix, Glendale, Chandler, it's ReactDefense.com, the home of Tactical Black. Brady, entertain me.
Christina Applegate is a breast cancer survivor.
Yeah.
Then she just got some bad news. The other day she has MS.
Yeah.
And they've shut down the production of her show on Netflix, Dead to Me.
She's great, too. Like, she turned into somebody that you thought was a trick pony on Married with Children.
I never thought she'd go any farther than
me
that.
Me too. Never. I don't think, and the sad part is the guy from that, David Faustino, he's just fine. No medical issues at all.
And is he alive?
Is he alive?
I don't know.
I think he's alive.
He's not doing anything.
It's not fair that somebody like Christina Applegate is the one that comes out of that thing. And you're like, you know what? America loves her. And Faustino goes on, healthy as a horse. My God, could we give him some MS and get it off of her? If anybody from that cast deserves it. But it is kind of like she's been almost Meg Ryan great the entire time. Because I'm with you. I thought, that's it. Married with Children.
Yeah.
We'll see her play kind of Kelly the slut, and that's what she'll always be. But she's been funny in everything she's done, even in Anchorman, where she was just kind of the low-level vanilla part of the thing.
Oh, yeah, she did a great job.
She was great in it.
Yep. Still, the old movie is like, Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead.
Great.
Good stuff.
I forgot about that movie. She was great in that. Was that during the Married with Time?
I believe
it was, yeah.
It was just the character they painted her as on the show.
And she was really hot, but never to the point where you were thinking, you know, she was out of your league. She always held that, you know, it's a weird thing guys think. If you met her, you'd think, oh, Kelly might like me. She wouldn't.
The NFL says taunting penalties will be strictly enforced this season.
Two and you're out. Two tauntings and you're out.
The hell's going on with this league?
Don't taunt me, Brett. That's one.
Yeah. Jennifer Lopez got a pink diamond from Ben Affleck back in the day in 2002. When he bought the ring, it was estimated to be worth $2.5 million. Well, the ring, the pink diamond, came out of an Australian mine that has been closed.
Uh-oh.
Now?
They stole it?
No, the mine closed down, so the diamonds that are coming out of there are rare.
good.
So they just went up in value. That ring is now worth $11 million.
I saw on TMZ yesterday they were spotted house hunting already. The Bennifer.
Yeah.
Looking at an $85 million place.
And they're also looking at Bob Hope's old place, too.
I mean, it's unreal. Yeah. Over, oh, and Toluca Lake?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. I actually tried to drive by that once and was escorted away before I even got to the street you turn on. People know that if you're just driving along in a rental car in Los Angeles and you're in Toluca Lake, I'm like, oh, I can just make a left here. It's like some guy standing there just going, turn it around, Enterprise, you're out.
That's why the rental cars have low jack, John. They track you. They don't track anyone else. They track you.
That's true. Well, he's over by Aniston's house again. The car died. What's why are all these police here so quickly?
Michaela,
look here, Selena. We don't have time for this.
Michaela Maroney is selling an NFT of her not impressed meme. Wow. It's on the auction block. It ends tonight at 10 p.m.
She must be out of money, too.
Current bid is $48,000.
That'll hold you over for a while, Michaela. But those Geico ads are great. You know, in the olden days, what you'd have to do is pose and Playboy. But those days are over.
Damn it.
I used to like it when hot former athletes ran out of cash and didn't have any more notoriety, and Playboy would call and go, give you $100,000 if you just take your shirt off. And yeah. That was when America was great. Trump was right about
that. For the olden days.
You're thinking old school, though.
Yeah.
The new Playboy is OnlyFans.
It is true, but she can't do that because it's slutty. Playboy was the last classy show your cans thing. OnlyFans, you're surrounded by whores. You're like, I'm trying to be classy here on OnlyFans. You can't. You can't have an OnlyFans page and say, yeah, but I keep it super classy.
Yeah.
Okay, OnlyFans.
The current Jeopardy champ, Matt Amadio.
This dude's amazing.
15 straight games as of last night. His total is $475,000.
And the other night he had $50,000 and going into Final Jeopardy, and he bet all but 10 of it because the other people had like 60. He just blasted everybody. And he missed it, so he only ended up with 10. He could be over 500. And he's annoying because he doesn't say who is or where is as his question. He just says what's. So if the answer is Marcus Meng, it's like, this man, into the pit, Sunday night, 9 to midnight, and the devil shows up at a radio station in Phoenix. He goes, what's Meng? Everything. What's Tlacopaki? Everything's what's.
There was a custom toy maker that made a Fred Durst action figure, basically his Dad Rock look with the silver medium length hair and his Hulk Hogan style mustache. And he put it up for auction. Fred actually bid on it, but he got outbid at the last minute. He would only pay $415 for his one off. The winning bid paid $680. There's a total of 54 bids. Fred posted a picture on Instagram and said, I lost the auction on this illegal toy.
That is
so now
true.
Now he's pissed off.
Yeah. Well, he should.
I didn't win, so.
He knew he was going to be mad. He should break some stuff. All right. Is that it?
Yeah.
Well done, Brady. Nice job. Into the Pit is Sunday nights, 9 to midnight, right here. Summon the Beasts of Hell with Marcus Meng. That's what you should have called the show. Summoning the Beasts of Hell. Brought to you by Geico.
I don't want to pigeonhole myself, John.
Yeah, but I know if you had a sponsor, that would have been awesome. Satan's Best Friend, sponsored by Frank's Hot Dogs.
Yankee Candle.
The teddy bear, New Hampshire teddy bear, whatever that thing was.
Teddy Grahams?
Teddy Grahams.
Oh, trust me.
Not Teddy Grahams. It was it was a Teddy Graham. You'd
it
get
was,
like a little. Glenn Beck used to cry and talk about those all the time.
Some of the commercials are a little
questionable.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, that was added value.
It was the pajama gram.
Well, no, it was the teddy bear. Vermont teddy bear is what it was called. Bear. It would be, are Hopkins and I ever talking about stuff on your show? Hey, it's John Holberg here for Doug Hopkins. Hey, if you're looking to get rid of your haunted dwelling during Into the Pit.
Actually, that's where to actually buy a haunted dwelling. People who listen want the haunted dwelling.
That's a good point. Yeah, I'm trying to. Well, I'll add that in the next spot.
I'm looking for a new coffin if Doug has any leads.
There's Vermont Teddy Bear. Brought to you by Vermont Teddy Bear. Now back to the hell sounds of Marcus. Into the Pit, 9 to
we'll
midnight.
We'll make that happen.
Sundays. Oh, we can do it. That's it for us. We're done. Larry McFeely's coming up next. Be kind to Larry. We'll see you tomorrow right here in the Morning Sickness. So long!
You were right, man! We should do this thing!
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite,
Repeat, ericsfamilybbq.com.